Tonight, a Republican congressman saying he won't run for re-election in part because he is inundated with questions about Stormy Daniels. Pennsylvania Congressman Ryan Costello telling the New York Times, quote, "If I had a town hall this week, it would be question after question. Do you believe him or do you believe her? Why don't you believe her?" Now, Costello, to be clear, has said he believes the women. This is Stormy Daniels' attorney tells CNN that 8 women have come forward in total to him with stories of alleged affairs with the president. The question is, though, does this matter when it comes to him staying in the White House? Does it matter to women voters? Miguel Marquez is out front.
After we had been intimate, he tried to pay me.
The allegations of extramarital affairs.
He leaned around and looked at my daughter and said, "It's a beautiful little girl. It'd be a shame if something happened to her mom." And then he was gone.
And claims of threats leveled at adult film actress Stormy Daniels for going public with her story.
You still like the president and approve the job?
I love the president. I love everything he does.
Hasn't shaken the president's most ardent supporters.
Just because she's a porn star or just because she's a playmate, I don't care. You know, that's personal, and I think she should keep it personal.
But for some Republicans who support the president today,
I wish that sometimes his speech was more kind and more professional.
Lydia McAvoy is an elected official in Clay County, the tax collector. She says the president's behavior has her considering options for 2020.
And support another Republican if someone came along in the primary?
Potentially. It would depend on who it was. I mean, it would depend if they could still put forth the same voice and the same values, but maybe do it in a different way.
In Parkville, a picture postcard, Kansas City suburb, allegations from the porn star and the playmate about the president, for some voters, serve only as confirmation.
Does that play into your opinion of him?
Kind of going into the original election, there were, you know, talks of things going on. I already had a low opinion of him to begin with.
At a gathering of Republican women in next door Clay County, the allegations are viewed as old news.
Everyone does something in their past, and I'm not saying that he did anything in his past. It just doesn't bother me.
It is between he and God about what he has done in the past, and that's what we're talking about, the past. What we are working now with him for is our future.
But the president's behavior might just be creating problems for his immediate political future. Missouri is home to one of the most competitive Senate races in the country. The president has visited here 3 times, throwing his support behind Republican Josh Hawley, who wants to unseat the Democratic incumbent, Claire McCaskill.
Apathetic voter. That's what I've always been.
Dislike of Trump has turned apathetic suburban independent non-voters like Alexis Webb Bechtold into a certain vote against the president in November.
I'm not excited about the people who have staunchly stood next to him and said, "Yay, he's really awesome," because he's not.
Now, the president and the Republican Party should be on easy street in places like Missouri. He won the Show Me State by 19 points. But in places like where I'm standing, the suburbs of Kansas City behind me, he's not only driving away Democrats, but also independents and even some Republicans, driving them away from himself and his party. Aaron?
All right. Thank you very much, Miguel, from Parkville, Missouri. And now, co-chair of the Women Vote Trump PAC, Amy Kremer, and Democratic strategist Keith Boykin. Keith, you know, first to you, I know there were 2 women that stood out to me there speaking to Miguel, basically saying, this is the past. This is between him and God. That hasn't changed, right? So more women coming forward, more disgusting stories, and they're not worried about it.
Well, yeah, I'm not entirely surprised. I mean, 2 fact points to add to this. First, in the election in 2016, 53% of white women voted for Donald Trump, 94% of black women voted for Hillary Clinton. Second data point, if you look at a survey that was conducted in 2016, 30% of evangelicals in 2016 said they had a problem with a politician who had moral failings. But when Barack Obama was president in 2011, 72% of white evangelicals had a problem with people, politicians who had problems like that. So there's clearly a hypocrisy there going on between white evangelicals who were so critical of Bill Clinton and Barack Obama, and they accuse them of moral failings. But when Donald Trump comes in office, they're willing to excuse it. He said he could stand in Fifth Avenue and shoot somebody, there wouldn't be any consequences. Okay. And clearly that's the case.
The one question, Amy, though, is whether all of this does move on the margin. You look at the white women who voted from 52, 53%, right? If that goes down to 47, 48, he could lose the whole thing on re-election, right? So those women, I mean, you could look at any group and about how much it matters, but that group in particular. And there we did see one Republican woman say, I'll vote for anybody that isn't him, even if I don't give a hoot about him, because I am upset. And the other woman saying, it's not professional and I don't like it. Are those warning signs for you?
I think that the president was elected to do a job. He was elected because people wanted him to go in and shake things up in Washington, D.C. We saw it in the election, both with Bernie Sanders and Hillary Clinton, that the people across the country are tired of the status quo, whether it be Democrats or Republicans. They were tired of it. They wanted change. A lot of independents and Democrats, too, voted for President Trump to be that disruptor and to focus on national security, jobs, and the economy. And he is doing that. And at the end of the day, we can take polls until the end of time, but really all that matters is on election day. And I believe that people vote with their pocketbook. This is all a bunch of noise. And I'll say this, Aaron, where I live in Roswell, Georgia, I mean, people don't wake up and go to CNN Politics or Politico or Axios like all of us who, you know, feed off of politics. They get up, they take care of their families, and what they care about is, do they have a job? Can they put food on their table?
So
can they
send their kids to college? To this point, the Wall Street Journal today wrote its lead editorial, about the issue of Stormy Daniels. They think it's a serious issue, and they wrote in part, this is why. Many Trump partisans will refuse to believe it or claim it's irrelevant, but our guess is that at the margin, this contributes to a growing public belief that Mr. Trump's personal flaws are undermining his chances for a successful presidency. That's the big issue. They may not read every in and out, but I'll tell you one thing they all know about. They all know about Stormy Daniels on 60 Minutes.
Yeah, but sex sells.
I don't think the sex part of this is selling at all. I got to be honest with you. I think that part's pretty disgusting.
Amy is claiming that
people aren't paying attention to this, and the president is focused on other issues and national security and the economy. But the president was the same. Donald Trump was the same one who said that if Hillary Clinton got elected, the country would be engaged in scandal watching, and so nothing would be accomplished. That's exactly what's happening right now.
We thought he was a preacher or a pastor.
You said that on Saturday, and I think that's highly inappropriate and hypocritical.
Why is it hypocritical?
Here's why. Okay, Amy, you defend Donald Trump despite all the pussy grabbing and the playmates and all the other stuff that's going on with the porn stars. You defended Roy Moore after he was accused of child molestation.
You defended Donald Trump despite all of that.
But when Barack Obama was president, you were on CNN on this very air on this very network, and you know what you said? Barack Obama doesn't love America. What's the difference between Barack Obama, Roy Moore, and Donald Trump? I'll tell you what the difference is. Barack Obama is a black man, and those two are white men.
White Republican men
you're willing to defend.
But you think Barack Obama does.
You should be better than that. You think that Barack Obama does not love America, but you support Donald Trump and Roy Moore, a segregationist. You support a segregationist.
Anybody that wants to fundamentally change America.
Roy Moore supported segregation. That fundamentally changes America. And you support that?
Amy, if Barack Obama had an incident like this with a porn star, will you admit that the treatment of it would have been totally different?
I mean, I think we are at a different place in time. And I was on air this morning, but
can you answer that question honestly? Can we all just admit the treatment would have been different with a black president having an affair while he's married with a porn star with his wife sitting with a baby?
Are you a hypocrite or a bigot? Which is it? This is illogical. You can't tell me that it wouldn't be the same thing with Barack Obama. Barack Obama couldn't even wear a tan suit without being accused of violence.
I never said one thing about what Barack Obama wore. But you said he didn't love America. I like Barack Obama as a person. I don't like his ideology. That's what I don't like. He does not love America on this network.
And now you defend Donald Trump and you defend Roy Moore.
Let me answer you. Barack Obama said he wanted to fundamentally change America. I don't believe if you love this country, why would you want to fundamentally
change? Donald Trump said, make America great again. That's fundamentally changing America. Roy Moore wanted to bring back segregation. That's fundamentally changing America.
All right. We'll leave it there. Thank you both.
And I think you're above that.
You should be above defending Roy Moore and Donald Trump.
Next.